Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, we will be showing you how to set up Batocera on a Raspberry Pi. This software is very similar to RetroPie in that it converts your Raspberry Pi into a retro gaming machine. The advantage of using Batocera over RetroPie is that it is a lot more plug and play and a bit more user friendly. While development on RetroPie has slowed down over the years, the Batocera team is definitely going a lot stronger. They continue to push out major updates at least twice a year. Now, for the best experience, we highly recommend that you use the latest available Raspberry Pi. At the time of recording, this would mean the Raspberry Pi 5. The reason for this is that the more performance, the better. With a Raspberry Pi 5, you'll be able to have much smoother performance and be able to emulate even more games. However, with that said, you could even still use a Raspberry Pi 0, you just have to make sure you only attempt to emulate weak systems, such as the original NES. Now to get started, we will need to download the latest version of the Batocera image. To do this, you'll need to open up your favorite web browser and go to https://batocera.org/download. Once you're on this page, toggle on the Raspberry Pi filter to just list versions of Batocera that will work on your Pi. Now scroll through this list and click the download button belonging to the version of Raspberry Pi that you are using. In our case, this will be the Raspberry Pi 5. Once downloaded, we'll want to open up the Raspberry Pi imager. If you haven't installed this before, we'll leave a link to this below. The imager is one of the best ways of installing operating systems to a supported storage device for the Raspberry Pi. This includes installing Batocera. With the imager open, click the Choose OS button, and then scroll down to the bottom and click the Use Custom option. This will bring up a file browse option that you'll need to use to select the Batocera image you downloaded previously. Now that we have selected our Batocera image that we want to write to our storage device, we will need to select the storage device. To do this, click the Choose Storage button. On here, select the device that you want to write the Batocera image to. For our guide, this will be our 64GB microSD card. Once everything is selected, click the Next button to proceed. You'll now be asked if you want to apply OS customization settings. Select the No option to continue. The Batocera image isn't officially supported within the Raspberry Pi imager, so this is more likely to cause more issues than not. You'll now be warned that all existing data on your chosen device will be erased. If you're happy to proceed, click Yes. Once Batocera has been written to the SD card or USB drive, unplug it and then plug it into your Raspberry Pi and power it on. When Batocera first starts up, it'll resize its partition to fill up the entire storage device. You've now successfully gotten Batocera up and running on your Raspberry Pi. The first thing you'll probably want to do is plug in a controller. For our example, we'll be plugging in our Xbox controller. When you plug in a controller, you'll be asked if you want to configure it. To remap a controller, hold down any button on the device. Now follow the prompts to map your controller to the controls shown on your screen. Once you're done, select the OK button. If you ever want to configure these later on, you can do through the main menu. You can bring up the main menu by either pressing the Escape key on a keyboard or by pressing the Start button that you configured on your controller. Now on this screen, select the Controller and Bluetooth Settings option. On this screen, you can see that you can remap your controller as well as control Bluetooth controllers. If you have a Bluetooth controller that you want to sync with your Batocera installation, this is the screen you'll want to use. Now, if you aren't using an Ethernet connection to your Raspberry Pi, you'll probably want to enable Wi-Fi. Luckily, we can enable Wi-Fi for our Raspberry Pi directly through Batocera's interface. Now, open the main menu by either pressing Escape or the Start button, and then select the Network Settings option. On this screen, go down and toggle on the Enable Wi-Fi option. Your Raspberry Pi might feel like it's frozen up for a second as Batocera enables the Wi-Fi functionality of your Raspberry Pi. Once enabled, you'll want to select the Wi-Fi SSID option. Here, you'll see a list of Wi-Fi networks that can be seen from your Raspberry Pi. Select the one that you want to connect to and to continue. Next, select the Wi-Fi key option and enter the password for your Wi-Fi network. Once everything is configured, you will now want to press the back button. If everything has worked properly, you will now see a message saying Wi-Fi enabled. Your next step will be to copy games over to your Batocera installation running on your Raspberry Pi. The best and easiest way to do this is over your network using the Samba shares that were automatically set up by Batocera when you started the software. For this guide, we'll be opening the File Explorer on our Windows computer. However, these steps should also work on other operating systems with slight adjustments. Samba is a super well-supported protocol for sharing files. Once open, we'll change to the Network tab. As long as your Raspberry Pi is connected to the network, you should see an option here called Batocera. Double tap it to begin connecting. Alternatively, you can double tap the address bar and type in // followed by the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. When you connect, you'll be asked to enter a username and password. Use the username root and the password Linux, and then hit the OK button. You'll now see two folders, root and share. The one you're after is the share folder. You'll now see a list of different folders. There are two key ones that you'll be interested in, and that is the BIOS one. This is where you'll copy any BIOS files to. And then the other one is the ROMs directory. Inside this folder, your ROMs will need to go into the relevant folders. For example, a SNES game would go into a folder called SNES, or a PlayStation 1 game would go into a folder called PSX. Once you have copied your games, you'll want to return to your Raspberry Pi. There's a few things you'll need to do to get Batocera to notice the games that you've freshly copied over. Back in Batocera, open the main menu by pressing Escape or the Start button. Now, select the Game Settings option. Next, select Update Game Lists, and then when prompted to actually update the game list, select Yes. Batocera will now quickly restart and load in all of the games that you've just copied across. To get metadata for these games, you'll want to open the main menu again, but this time select the Scraper option. For this guide, we will be changing the default scraper. Even though Screen Scraper provides you with a lot better metadata, it requires you to sign up before you can use it. So to make things a bit simpler for this guide, we will be changing it to the GameDB. Once done, select the Scrape Now option. Batocera will now scan all your games and get any available metadata from the chosen database. This process can take a little while to complete. Once it is done, we will want to switch back to the Game Settings screen again, and then select Update Game Lists, and then select Yes. Batocera will now restart, but this time we'll load in all your new games with the new metadata. To show you this all working, let's switch to Sega Mega Drive and launch the free game called Old Towers. This is a free homebrew game that was developed for the Sega Mega Drive in 2019. If you ever want to exit out of a game that is currently running on Batocera on your Raspberry Pi, you'll want to press whichever button you set to be the hotkey key as well as the start button at the same time. At this point, you should hopefully have Batocera up and running on your Raspberry Pi as well. If you found this guide to be helpful, please be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.